بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أما بعد. This is Arabic class number 9 part 2. Arabic class number 9 part 2. أين مدرس هو في الفصل وأين مدرس الجديد هو عند المدير أين طالب الجديد ذهب إلى المكتبة من ذلك الرجل الطويل طويل الذي خرج الآن من المدرسة هو المدير الجديد ومن الولد الصغير الذي خرج الآن من الفصل من تلك السيارة الجميلة هي للمدير هي للمدير الجديد لمن هذا الكتاب الكبير أهو للمدرس لا هو للطالب الجديد أين الملعقة الصغيرة هي في الكوب أين الكرسي المكسور هو هناك. In this second part of the lesson, lesson number 9, it goes over a couple of points just as the first one did. The first one of part 2 is القاعدة إن النعت يتبع المنعوت في التنكرة والتعريف وفي الإعراب مثلا هذا المدرس جديد ومثلا أخرى هذا المدرس جديد. And this قاعدة is indeed the نعت follows the منعوت in it being a definite article or indefinite article, a definite article or indefinite article, and also in i'rab, in the letter at the end of the words. An example of that is هذا المدرس جديد. This is تنكر. This is تنكر. This is indefinite. This is indefinite. Next example is هذا المدرس جديد. This is تعريفة. The definite article and an indefinite article. And indeed we went over this point regarding نكر ومعرفة. But even the word is different in the chapter, but it has the similar meaning. So when the thing that's being described has aleph and lam, then the description has aleph and lam. If the thing that is being described does not have aleph and lam, then the description does not have aleph and lam. The next thing it goes over, it gives a question. ما فرق بين, what is the difference between هذا الكتاب كبير in وهذا الكتاب كبير. Let me read it again. What's the difference between, they give you two sentences. The first sentence is هذا الكتاب كبير. And the next one is هذا الكتاب كبير. And the difference between the sentence is ففي الجملة الأولى, in the first sentence كبير is the خبر. كبير is the خبر. ففي جملة الثاني, and in the second sentence كبير not, that the كبير is not. And we gotta go back to the sentence so you can understand is that the first sentence says هذا الكتاب كبير. Now from this lesson, the second part of the lesson and also in the first part of the lesson, what we learned that the not must follow the man'ut in masculinity and femininity. And in this lesson, this part of the lesson, we learned that the not must follow the man'ut in being nakira or ma'rifa, being definite or indefinite. And if you look into the sentence, you will see that it says al-kitabu aleph alam on the kitab kabirun, no aleph alam on the kabirun. So this scene like that we know that the min'ut, the not is not following the min'ut, because the min'ut is aleph alam, but the not doesn't, so it's not considered not or min'ut. That's why kabir in that sentence is considered the khabar. Then we go on to the second chapter. The second sentence says kitabun kabirun. Now look, now the not is following the min'ut, the Man'ut is indefinite. And the Na'at is indefinite. So, we see with that, that this is Na'at wa Man'ut. This is an importance of looking, when we read Arabic, we must pay attention to what is being read. Because if you read that real fast and don't pay attention, you would think that it's, the sentences are the same. But actually it's not. One is Na'at wa Man'ut, and the other one is Mubtada wa Khabar. But it's using the same words, it's the changes in the different words. And the point that it goes over now is Asma'ul Mawsula. Asma'ul Mawsula. The nouns of connection. A noun to connect the sentence. And this noun is Alladhi, which is masculine. And later on in the book we will go over the feminine of that, which is Allati. But this one right here is Alladhi. Alladhi. It's called Asma'u Mawsula. Asma'u Mawsula. The nouns of connection. And it gives you, and this is not too much of a detail, but just to give you, you have four different sentences. You have Kitabul Alal Maktabi. Then you have Al-Kitabu Lil Mudarrisi. Then you have Alladhi. Now you can put these two sentences together and make it one and put them both together, but you add Alladhi in it and makes it a whole complete sentence. And this first part is Al-Kitabu Ala Al-Maktabi. Then you have Kitabu Lil Mudarrisi. Now I'm going to add Alladhi to both of them sentences and make it one complete sentence and make it be known, make it be understand. And one of the qaidas of speech is that it must be mufid, that it must be beneficial. So I will make this benefit. I will make this to put these both sentences together to make them beneficial. Al kitabu alladhi ala al maktabi lil mudarrisi. Al kitabu alladhi ala al maktabi lil mudarrisi. The book which is upon the table belongs to the teacher. SubhanAllah, how beautiful the Arabic language is. And this is the end of lesson 9. Anything I said that was incorrect is from myself and the shaitan. And anything that I said that was correct, then all the praise is due to Allah. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.